All right, so how is everyone?
Good. Enjoying Black Hat? For the recent years, attack paths have become a very common way of looking at AD and looking at ways to get into AD. The problem that we found, the big challenge there, is that looking from an attacker perspective, and we've all heard this millions of times, attackers only need one way in, right? So give me the millions of or thousands of attack paths into AD, I just need one, I'll take advantage of that and I'll hit AD. But as blue teams, as defenders, we need to be able to close all of those, right? So using a tool that gives us thousands of attack paths, it's very difficult to use. So what we really want to be able to do is kind of isolate that perimeter that we want to protect. There is a kind of a default perimeter, right? Microsoft defined tier zero as our kind of administrative tier for managing Active Directory. But tier zero, in fact, is much larger than just the domain controller or just the domain admins group, right? Because you're going to have nested groups. You're going to have certain types of apples. You're going to have certain privileges that let certain principles take over other objects within the tier zero group. And if those principles are legitimate, if you do need a certain service account or a certain user with generic write all or something like that on an object that's tier zero, then you need to consider that specific user as tier zero as well. And you need to treat them as tier zero and you need to monitor them. You need either to mitigate those permissions and remove them, or you need to start doing monitoring and you need to start doing whatever remediation you want to do on that. But to be able to do that, you need to understand your tier zero perimeter. So that's what we want to do with Forest Druid. We want to be able to classify our actual security zone, what is really tier zero. So we've taken what we're calling an inside-out approach to attack paths in order to be able to do that. Attack paths, usually what is being done is we map all of them and we look from the outside in. So we find some normal user that through, you know, 5, 6, whatever many hops, can get us some kind of domain admin access or some kind of privileged access. And we've kind of flipped this around. So we initially focus only on tier zero, and then we want to look around tier zero, see who has access there, start asking ourselves, wait, is that yellow dot there, does that really need this type of access? Yes or no? If the answer is no, we put it in our remediation list, okay? If the answer is yes, that this access really is required, then we put that in our actual tier zero perimeter. And the end result of this is that we then get two lists. One list is the things that we need to remediate to make sure that our tier zero is secure, that our administrative zone is secure. And the second list is the actual principles that we need to protect and we need to monitor, because these are our actual security perimeter. So an example of that. Let's say we have a tier zero object, let's say a domain controller, and security principle A, let's say it's a user, they have some high level access to that domain controller. Now that user may not be in the domain admin group. They might be an old user that was moved out. They might be something else. Now we need to ask ourselves, is this okay? Is this access legitimate? Okay, just looking at principle A. If the answer is yes, if that's okay, we now need to treat object A as a tier zero object and ask ourselves the same question about object B. Our goal is to understand where we want to prune, where we want to cut off that attack path. Okay, so by looking inside out instead of outside in, usually we'd have to start looking with object C. Okay, and then start collecting a list of hundreds, maybe thousands of attack paths that may have, you know, 4 hops, they may have 5, they may have 8. You know, we've seen 15 hop attack paths and so on. It's impossible to do in larger environments. I have an environment here with 250 users and I got something like 85 attack paths. It's really impossible to do this methodically over time, over and over again. When we do it this way, we isolate that security perimeter. And every time that a new object has some kind of takeover relationship into tier zero, we look at it, we ask ourselves, is this legitimate, isn't it? If not, we remediate. If it is, we add it to our monitoring groups with whatever monitoring solutions we have. So what does that look like? So this is Forest Druid. It's split up into two parts. This part is our graph. And this is a large environment. This is an environment I have with about 5,000 users. It's not that large, but it is convoluted. I just ran some scripts that pretty much randomly assigned permissions. So this usually your graph will be a lot cleaner, and I'll show you a smaller graph real soon. But your goal here is to look at these blue objects. The blue objects are your default tier zero. Okay, so what you're gonna see when you run this is you're gonna see some blue objects pop up, and around them, you'll see those yellow objects. The yellow objects are those principles that have some kind of takeover relationship or some kind of high privileges into tier zero. These same things also appear on the left side, right? So we're just focusing on one hop out from tier zero. That's it, that's all we wanna look at. And then we have that list on the left side. We wanna iterate through it, we wanna go through it. We wanna mark those that we know to be legitimate. We want to click on them, and we want to mark them as tier zero. So I'm going to click on a few of them here. Skip them ahead a little bit. We can also traverse the graph a little bit. We can click on these objects and see their details. We can do the classification from the graph itself. We can also search for objects. So in this case, I'm going to show you in a bit of video where I'm seeing those DC sync privileges on the PK report, and then I'm actually going to search for that user here and see what that looks like on the graph. Okay, so what I'm doing here, I'm marking an object as tier zero. So you see this green dot here. Once you define a specific relationship to be legitimate, you select it and mark it as tier zero, and then new objects will appear because there could be new objects that now have tier zero access. If I was to do the outside in approach, I would have the whole thing on my screen right now. I would have about 2,000 nodes to go through. Here what I have are 98 relationships that I have to review on this large environment. When we run this without any privilege escalation turned on. Privilege escalation is that specific point where you move from a lower tier to a higher tier, right? That's where you escalate. When we focus on that, we have 98. When we don't focus on that, we have hundreds. Okay, so really what we're trying to do, lower that number, right? Bring it down. Okay, and there my graph explodes, right? So I marked one of these as tier zero, and all of a sudden I find that this is some kind of generic or some kind of default privilege within that group that everybody's assigned that privilege. So by marking this guy as tier zero, what that actually means is that I just enabled a lot of inbound attack paths into tier zero. So what I actually want to do is either remove that generic alt privilege that exists within that group or somehow prune this relationship here, either through some kind of removal of that permission or by some other means. Okay, but this is a very dangerous situation because what we have here are a bunch of principles that have strong privileges on another principle that has tier zero access. And you see we went up from 98 to 234. Okay, so when you're using this tool, if you hit on something like this, then this is a choke point. This is something that you're gonna wanna remove. All right, so this is what the graph looks like after I mark these, and you can see them very clearly, right? So you can see that you can identify that these here are what I want to take care of, right? Because just by treating this one here and this one here as a tier zero, as a privileged object, that opens up a lot of attack paths. So this gives us the ability to play around with our graph, the ability to kind of simulate what will happen if I leave these permissions in place and what that exposes me to. And then also I can go back to AD, remove those permissions, resync the graph and see what that does. Another thing I can do, I click this button. What that does, it condenses all of tier zero into one node. So when you do have very large graphs to look at, this is just a simpler way of seeing what's happening. And if I increase those hops, Okay, so here I'm going to search for that DC sync. So this is Catherine Hughes. This is the same user that has those that had those DC sync privileges. I'm going to focus on that for a second. Okay, you can't see it too well on the screen, but once you focus on that, everything else becomes dimmer, and only that specific path is highlighted. So I can move the graph around to focus on that. Okay, and I see that that path that leads in. So I'm going to classify it as tier zero. And you saw me doing that right-clicking on the graph itself. You can do it that way. So what you're looking at, I ran a Purple Knight report, and I found that Catherine Hughes has DC sync privileges on my domain controller. And then when looking at the graph here, I said, well, I'm actually going to treat this user as a tier zero user. Okay, and that's fine. But when I did that, when I simulated that here, what I found was that I now have additional objects, right, even groups, that by just by effectively treating that user as tier zero, then we've got additional attack paths into tier zero just by having that in place. And that's something we want to know about. And we increased the number of privilege escalation points. All right, so I'm actually going to reclassify it as risky. And that when I export the data, when I complete the work here, I'm going to export the data, and it's going to send all of the objects. It's going to create a CSV file with all of those objects and relationships that I need to remediate, right? So everything that's marked as risky, and everything by default, all of these orange nodes are going to be marked as risky by default because they are privilege escalation points. We're going to get all of those as part of our export, okay? And everything we marked as tier zero, we're going to get all of that as well. All right, I'm just going to show you a couple more things. We were actually able to simulate finding an IOC in this case and using Forest Druid. And the way that we do that is by running this and looking specifically again at DC sync rights, we found this SID. Okay, so I'm gonna sort this by the type of access. You see that I have these get changes access, and I've got these several users, right? So let's say three of them are legitimate, and the other one I just get a SID. Okay, I'm not able to resolve that. So it'll do is I'll do an LDAP query, or I'll do some kind of AD query, and I'll find that it is a removed object. It's actually a deleted object. Okay, now this often happens for legitimate purposes. Okay, we remove the user, but we didn't go in and remove the actual permissions from the domain head. And that's why this will happens very often when we don't completely clean up. So this is usually for lack of hygiene, but it could also represent an attacker having created this user and then removed them. So it is something we want to look into. Okay, this is what a larger domain looks like. Okay, we can look at the graph on full screen. We can also also see all of the titles. Okay, so really what we're trying to do here, and the goal of releasing this as a community tool, is to get your feedback. So hopefully you'll all use this and give us feedback both on the types of edges we can add, the types of relationships that are interesting to you, as well as the usability aspects of the tool itself. This is kind of an experimental UX, and we want to understand from you if this helps you understand your AD, right? It's difficult to get a visualization and to really get visibility into what our directory looks like. And we believe this is a helpful way of doing that by just trying to define our perimeter based on those nodes or those principles that we want to treat as privileges, as privilege, that we need to treat as privilege, right? That have this access. We can do that either through a grab view. We can also do a full screen list view as well. Any questions? Yeah, thank you. He was asking, the gentleman was asking if in addition to the inside out approach, do we also need to do the outside in approach, right? Do we also need to do the attack path analysis? And it really depends on the methodology and how you're protecting your environment. if you do subscribe to the attacker focused view, you want to see how attackers view your environment and the attack pass that they might take advantage of, then it makes sense to do that as well. If you want a methodology to map out your zone and to understand your security perimeter and be able to monitor that, then this is a better approach. It's really a matter of what you're trying to do. The attack path view is just is the notion of combining multiple attacks or multiple hops to create one single attack. And if you want to see all of the possibilities, think like an attacker, do a red team exercise, understand what's easier to do, what's harder to do, then definitely the outside-in approach. If you really want to focus on getting visibility into what your domain, what your AD and Azure AD environments look like, and what are the actual strong privileges within the environment, then the inside-out approach is better. But yeah, combination of the two is probably the best depending on what you want to do. And by the way, we are adding Azure to this as well. Right now, initially, this only supports AD for the initial release. Any more questions? Thank you. So he's asking, how does it compare to Bloodhound? So Bloodhound is a great tool, again, for the outside-in approach. We want to understand how attackers can penetrate Active Directory. What are all the attack paths? What are the choke points that they have to get through to attack Active Directory? Very important tool, good tool, especially if you're doing red team exercises, especially if you're doing pen testing of your environment, then it's a great tool. This, again, is an inside-out approach. If you want to look at, if you want to draw your real tier zero perimeter, that's the goal here. So we're trying to achieve kind of two different, and I see them as complementary things. I think that this works together with the Bloodhound approach. Again, the attacker based view of how I can get in, how I can compromise a domain. I think there's no alternative to that. That still needs to be done. It does not replace though the visibility, the continuous visibility that you need as a blue team, as a defender, of what's really important to protect. There's no replacement for that. So unfortunately, we need to do both of them. Hopefully we have the resources to do that. But again, this is why it's a free tool, because we have our commercial tools that utilize these technologies, but it's very important to be able to just get this view of what we're trying to protect. Thank you. I hope you all download this and give us your feedback through our Slack channels, through email, whatever means necessary. I'm the product manager. Ishai is the product manager. We love to hear from you. Download it and give it a try. Thank you.